Hi, it's Open Zone's Real Thoughts, and today I'm going to be reviewing Ryan Coogler's new film, Fruitvale Station. Fruitvale Station first premiered at the Sundance Film Festival, which won its Grand Jury Prize and the Audience Award for Dramatic Feature. Because of such great hype and buzz, it showed at the LA Film Festival. First-time director Ryan Coogler's Fruitvale Station follows the true life story of Oscar Grant, a 22-year-old Bay Area resident who was unjustly killed on the New Year's Eve of 2008 on Fruitvale Station in Oakland, California by the Oakland Police when they accidentally misfired. The story takes place on the last day of his life, December 31st, 2008, transitioning to 2009, from the crack of dawn to the early mornings of New Year's Day. And so Michael B. Jordan, who plays Oscar Grant, I first laid my eyes on Michael B. Jordan when he was in Chronicle, the sci-fi film last year. And I was just, you know, the film was amazing. And I was just kind of blown away by his presence on screen. I mean, he wasn't the main character, but he stood out so well, and I loved his character, and I was just like, who is this guy? Why don't I know about him? And I never saw The Wire, or I think he was in Friday Night Lights. And so I was just kind of amazed at his performance. And, you know, he captured Oscar Grant really well. Like, I mean, you know, I've never lived in Oakland, but I know those guys, not personally, but I've seen them, I've interacted with them, and they carry themselves like that with just such swagger, and those are real people, and he plays them so well, and it's so hard to emulate somebody who is so real that you see every day. And you know, the last day of his life is basically like Judgment Day, where he tries to change his life, where whether it is, you know, to stop selling weed or to get his job back or just be generally a better father to his daughter. Melanie Diaz plays his girlfriend, who I adore, and Octavia Spencer plays his mother. And you know, the story is quite simple, but there's such a beauty to it. You know, considering it's the very last day, there's just very, very, like, a strong aura about it. For the last 20 minutes, it's probably the most intense 20 minutes of your life, because you know it's coming. That anticipation, not anticipation, that anxiety, that intensity, that inevitability of his death is coming, and you know that it's real, which completely amplifies the intensity that much more. And so, you know, it's quite a ride, and it's emotional. I can say I got choked up quite a bit. And so, you know, the only minor thing I was dissatisfied is that, regardless of the story based on if it is based on real life or not, I don't like it when they make a character too sympathetic. And I mean, you know, I already feel for the guy. I don't need to I don't need them to play up his character so I really feel for him, because I already do, and I don't want that to feel so contrived or forced. I just, you know, it'll come naturally if it's real. And you know, I don't know if those things exactly happened, but or they were trying to stick with the story so well, but I mean, it worked well. Regardless of if it is true or not, it worked well to the story. And I always, when there's real life stories, I always think about, would this story have made as a big of an impact on me if it wasn't true? And so that's always a question to think about. But it, you know, the story is real, and I do feel for him. Yeah, that was the one thing I don't like, when they make characters too sympathetic, or they change up the scenario so it creates more drama. I don't think, you know, in some cases it's not necessary, but in movie making point of view, I mean, I'm sure they did it according to the story. And so, regardless of that, I really thought it was great. I just, it's a really powerful film, and elegant in their storytelling, and I love that it takes place on the last day of his life. I love that. So the film, the Fruitvale Station was a gala at the LA Film Festival. So, you know, everyone from Octavia Spencer to, you know, Melanie Diaz and like all the cast members showed up, even Forrest Whitaker because he was one of the head producers on the film. And, you know, Ryan Coogler, who is, this is his first film. Like, this is an amazing accomplishment for a first time director to have this much hype, this much buzz. And, you know, I can't wait to see where his career is going because he is so young and it just started. And so, you know, I'll be on the lookout for more of his projects in the future. And so, you know, go out and see it. It is a little heavy, so bring tissues or something. I don't know. Thanks for listening. Bye.